my spiritual experiences began happening when I was around 14 or 15 years old. I cannot remember what exact situation pulled me into this void of curiosity. However, there are some distinct events I can recall. Waking Life, a film by Richard Linklater, could have possibly been one of my first introductions into the existential questioning. The narrative follows a man who finds himself stuck in a dream world, cycling through different situations and conversations in hope of finding the solution to waking up. I always thought that was an excellent description of our life. Through watching this film, led me further down the rabbit hole and leaving me more questions than answers. At some point not long after watching Waking Life, I read a book by Robert Monroe called Journeys Out of the Body. The idea of travelling to dimensions beyond our physical body highly fascinated me, and so I began researching this area of interest immensely. I began trying to induce sleep paralysis, seeing this as a gateway into the higher dimensions, and with some success. Throughout these experiences, I was delving into the world of lucid dreaming and the skills of waking awareness in an unconscious state. The most I've ever been aware in a lucid dream was recognizing that outside of what I was perceiving in that dreaming state was my physical body laying in bed asleep. It was an incredibly mind-blowing and enlightening experience. At some point, my interest in this subject became numb and almost desensitized. My waking life became indulged in lots of pot smoking and MDMA. It wasn't until a few years after this that myself and a friend decided to take some LSD. However, looking back, I went into this experience with the wrong mindset. I was not prepared to witness and experience the things that came to me during this psychedelic trip. It all started off fine, and the conversations with my friend were very much entailing what most people experience during their first time taking psychedelics. We're all the same thing. There's only one, just an endless loop. At the time, my brain was witnessing things faster than I could properly process it, and in a few hours into the trip, my visuals suddenly peaked, time was warped, deja vu was incredibly strong, and I passed out on a beach late at night with my friend. Upon waking up, I didn't know what had happened, where I was, or even who I was. I remember sitting down, my friend trying to comfort me, and me saying, "I don't even know who I am." It was in that moment that I glimpsed a moment of the eternal, and my previous perspective of life had died. It was as if a part of myself died. After that day, and for almost a year, I did not know exactly what to make of that experience, until I once again returned to the world of psychedelia, and consumed a large quantity of LSA.
A thousand years is but an instant. There's nothing new, nothing different. Same pattern over and over. The same clouds, same music, the same as I felt an hour or an eternity ago. There's nothing here for me now, nothing at all. Now I remember, this happened to me before. This is why I left. You have begun to find your answers. Although it will seem difficult, the rewards will be great. Exercise your human mind as fully as possible, knowing it is only an exercise. Build beautiful artifacts, solve problems, explore the secrets of the physical universe, savor the input from all the senses, feel the joy and sorrow, the laughter, the empathy, compassion, and tuck the emotional memory in your travel bag. I remember where I came from and how I became a human, why I hung around, and now my final departure schedule. This way out, escaping velocity, not just eternity, but infinity.
I was visiting a friend that I had not seen in about a year. It was meant to just be a normal catch-up. I'd smoked some pot, and if I recall, I had a beer to drink. It was myself, my friend, and his partner. We decided to put on a movie and decided on watching Apocalypse Now. He'd offered me some of the morning glory seeds that he had grinded up and put inside capsules. I declined, mentioning, "I don't feel like going down the rabbit hole tonight." Quite ironic for what occurred later. However, it wasn't long before I had taken the capsule, cracking it open and putting the seeds underneath my tongue. My friend told me to leave it there, and after a while to swallow it. The visuals were initially very subtle, which included a slight increase in contrast, then later turned into rotoscope perception. As if it were cartoon, what I compare it to the most is waking life. When the visuals began to slightly fade, I decided to take yet again another capsule of the morning glory seeds. At some time around this point, I began to notice situations looping and repeating. I would find myself talking about the same thing, asking them if I had talked about this before the cycle would repeat again. This thought loop developed into a life of its own when I began trying to understand my perception of reality. I saw myself and felt myself pulling back the layers to this reality and feeling my ego dissolving rapidly. It got to the point where I had to try and keep reminding myself how I got to this place, my personal histories, all the while trying to grasp at this truth that was dangling in front of my face. In an abrupt moment, I had felt myself awaken, as if I had become lucid within this dream. I had noticed that these loops had happened before, not just in this incarnation, but was a reoccurring phenomenon of recursion and my ability to bring awareness to this eternity. I was highly delirious and delusional, believing in things that were simply not possible nor logical. It was as if I really believed I was in an unconscious dream state and that the laws of the world I knew were obsolete. Half of that statement is true. Life really is simply a dream. I saw the repetitive nature of the human condition, and it was amplified to its maximum capacity. This observation created immense fear and anxiety. I would keep forgetting this eternal repetitive truth, only to finally understand it again, before it suddenly disappeared. In a moment of deep thought and clarity, I'd felt a high connection to what is. But it felt wrong. It felt like I shouldn't understand this truth, and by doing so, would be corrupting my very own reality of what I understood as life. It was as if I was the software, and I was aware of the presence behind the machine. It was as if we both acknowledged one another, and both knew that this should have not been happening. This higher power communicated to me that it would be impossible to communicate this isness to my friend. That if I did, the powers that be would corrupt my message to complete hogwash and nonsense. This did not stop me from attempting to communicate what I was experiencing. And it turns out what I was trying to explain then, which I'm explaining now to my friend at the time, was incomplete sentences and gibberish. Becoming frustrated and even more scared at this discovery of the eternal being remembered and forgotten on loop, made me plea to my friend for sedatives. He gave me Seroquel, by memory about 50 milligrams, and I walked into the guest room and laid down on the bed in the dark. This is when the nausea began to kick in very hard, and I fought off the impulse to vomit. This is when my ego began to completely dissolve into nothingness. I continued to suppress the eternal realization thought loops, and this was becoming mentally exhausting. My heart was beginning to slow down a little, and my body began to seize up and shake in different places. I was experiencing death, at least that's what it felt like and what I understood that was happening to me at the time. It felt like I was experiencing the moment of death through everybody and everything that has existed. That we all experience the exact same thing upon arriving to death. I went through the feeling of grief and loss, knowing that I would no longer see my family again. That I would miss the earth and my experience upon it. After cycling through the stages of grief, I finally accepted my death. I had let go and my consciousness was suddenly just a singularity within complete blackness. Almost instantly, I felt my surroundings change. I knew exactly where I was, what had happened. I was transported back in time, to the time I had taken LSD and fainted on the beach. However, a higher power within me told me, "This is where you actually died. You never became conscious after this again. You suffered a seizure and died, here. What you are experiencing now is the grand hallucination of life." I could hear the waves on the beach, the coldness on the sand, and I opened my eyes to see the stars in the night sky. I recall feeling extremely frightened, filled with dread and doom. Before I knew it, I was transported to another event that happened in my life. Almost 3 months prior to having this LSA experience, I was involved in a drunk driving accident. I do not recall when I had crashed my car, but only waking up after the impact. I was told later that I had missed a telegraph pole by less than a meter, going roughly 80 kilometers an hour around a sharp bend. When I was transported back to this moment, I did not visually see the car accident, but I felt my essence was there. I knew I was there. Once again, something higher within me told me, "Here, once again, you died in this car accident. You only perceived your survival." I was then transported to my parents' house, and once again, not seeing where I was, but sensing where I was very strongly. Then I heard police knocking on my parents' door, waking them up, and delivering them the news that I had died in a car accident. I heard their cries and frustrations and mourning, which after I recall hearing my parents arguing and finally hearing glass shattering in some kind of dispute. Something within me told me that I was no longer needed here, and I felt my essence ascending skyward rapidly. At this stage, I saw a visual representation of the chakras in full color, and once again I was swept back into the conscious void of nothingness. This felt to me as almost an eternity, and I was dreading the idea of being stuck in nothingness, yet with still a consciousness. I knew that I was doomed to slowly go insane and dissolve into the abyss. Then I had a sudden realization. I wasn't dead. I was actually a fetus inside a womb, and I was being reborn into another life. I then realized that I had entered the multiverse, where I had witnessed different situations where I had died, and was reborn again to live the exact same life up until that moment. This thought, coupled with the eternal recursion realization thought loop, gave me an immense feeling of relief. After realizing that I was a fetus inside a womb, I do not recall what I experienced after that. I know at some point I fell asleep. Upon awakening the next morning, I was shocked to find that I was still alive, as far as I could perceive. For about a week or two, I was noticing myself at times becoming disassociated with reality and almost watching myself from a bird's eye view. It took me several months to finally process this experience. From what I can understand, I was faced with the eternal entailing all possibilities of multiple universes. My idea was that each single universe was created from the singularity known as the Big Bang, and at some point during the duration of the universe, I was born. I then died at some point, and time became temporarily extinct as my essence was brought to the edge of the universe before collapsing back in on itself, only to expand once again and for me to relive the same life, or a possibly different life, on repeat for eternity. Months of researching these ideas that I had encountered, I found one thought experiment by Friedrich Nietzsche to resonate with me the most. It was the proposal of eternal recurrence, questioning our reaction to the idea of living the same life for eternity. About a fortnight ago, I found a video online titled Loop Theory. Watching this video was surreal, as the experience I had, the ideas I had thought of afterwards were explained exactly how I had perceived this event. It was as if I had seen this video before and for an eternity. I had felt that my understanding and experience was informed by this video, and that this video was informed by my understanding and experience. A complete paradox and a complete recursion. And at some point I realized that the meaning of this life was the pursuit of the meaning of life. We are for eternity forgetting this truth and chasing it, only to remember it and believe it completely, to once again lose it back into the void. And the byproduct to this pursuit of the meaning of life is discovering the eternal and the oneness, the now, the moment that is now and always has been and always will be.
Like eyes, the black night sky.